Hello, it's Chris.
And Tanisha Souza, and this is the TARDIS YouTube channel. And welcome to the channel today. Today we're going to talk about why your spouse or your partner is keeping you broke.
Broke.
just kidding. we're going to talk about relationships and money, and it's probably not your spouse or your partner is keeping you broke, but we'll get into that in more detail. So today we're going to focus on investing in money management styles and how important it is for you to discover your own money management style and your investing style.
Yeah.
And that of your spouse, and that you not only realize what each other's strengths and weaknesses are, but that you work together and really focus on each other's strengths and utilize both of those when managing your money and investing.
Yeah.
Okay. So we're both going to be kind of going back and forth here, just trying to explain to you a little bit about our differences, because we're actually opposites in how we manage our money and invest, but it's been great and it's been a challenge too. So we're going to talk to you a little bit about both, and I'll let Chris start with my money management style.
First off, she is called a gambler. Now, saying the personality style of money, a gambler, you kind of get what it means. But here's the great thing about them. They get up off the couch, they get moving, they see something, and they go after it. Where my style is more, I want to analyze and kind of go over it. She'll talk a little bit about that in a second. But so it's a great trait to have if you understand how important it is because of my personality style compared to your personality style. So it's more ready, shoot, aim. That type of person. So they have these great ideas.
What?
They run off.
What?
They run off and they go after it right away. But what happened is they leave a lot of details to the side because they have the bigger vision and they're going, yeah, I can do this. Let's go. And my personality type is behind going, wait. Hold on. Let's think about this. Let's do this. Let's talk about this. And so it's a good balance, but that's the gambler.
Right. And I want to clarify something about the gambler. It doesn't mean that you necessarily gamble, because I actually don't gamble. What it is it's the personality that tends to have a lot of ideas. They want to move quickly. They feel they move a lot based on their gut and their intuition more than data and analysis.
Yeah.
And so that's where a conflict could potentially occur, especially if when you're like us, which are opposites. So Chris, for example, is the investigator. So the investigator is more of the type of person who tends to want to research, do all of the due diligence before making a move. And that can be frustrating for somebody who wants to move quickly. So if you look at some of the challenges that may bring up, if you're not aware of your strengths and weaknesses or that of your partner, then one of the challenges is going to be that one of the challenges could be that you conflict. So we learned pretty early on that what we want to do is we want to get to that point where we utilize each other's strengths. Mm-hmm. I know what his strengths are. He knows what mine are. Mine, you know, I'm the idea queen. I may overdo it sometimes. You know, he sometimes tells me, no more ideas.
Stop.
Okay.
Let's finish the first one. Then we'll get to the next one.
And so sometimes that happens and I slow it down. And another thing that happens with him is we move forward and we create a lot of really cool things.
Yeah.
So we're a really good team. And you have to realize you are attracted to the person that you're with for a reason, because they're not exactly like you. And so those parts of your investing style, your money management style, is what they have. And so working together, you can actually avoid a lot of mistakes. Mm-hmm. You can go further, faster. What we've been able to accomplish in our 21 years of marriage is pretty phenomenal. I mean, a lot of people spend their whole lives and are not able to do what we've been able to do. And it's because we were able to pick up on this right away. So again, real quick, I'm going to recap. The gambler, which is me, I'm not really a gambler, but that's my style, is the one that, what did you say? How did you say it? Ready, shoot, aim?
Mm-hmm. Okay. Off to the races.
Okay, off to the races.
Like, whoa, where are you going?
And the investigator is the opposite of that, which tends to want to slow down. Let's analyze, let's research, let's get all of the data plus some and some more before we make a move.
Right.
And so, you know, again, that those two working together are a powerful combination.
Yeah.
We'll talk about some other combinations as well and some of the things that could go wrong. But did you have something else that you wanted
yeah.
to bring up?
When I see a lot of couples, I notice right away that I want to ask for both of them to be on the meeting. And sometimes one says, no, I'll just let the other one know. And we're like, oh, no. We want both of them there. And we know already for this reason, because one of them generally is one personality type and one is the other. And especially if the person who is a gambler hasn't like sat down and kind of gone over the numbers and everything with the spouse and has done another investment and the investment's gone bad, guess what?
Oh.
They're angry at everything and anything because they're not that type. It's crazy to them to not make sense at all to just go out there and start doing this. So I see that all the time. I see a lot of this in our calm counseling sessions.
Coaching
sessions. Yeah. And I hear it all the time from our coaches. So work together. Know that you guys have strengths and weaknesses, and the more you work together on them and see each other's for as benefits, the farther you guys will go on your finances quickly.
Yeah, and this goes back to what Chris was just saying, the importance of coaching, right? The importance of having a coach. Most mm-hmm. people have a hard time. He joked that it's sort of like a counseling session, but that's how some of the coaching sessions end up being when spouses don't talk about money. So another situation where we see this arise is where one spouse sees these goals and has these visions and the other spouse seems like they're not on board.
Yeah.
So the other spouse just goes for it and doesn't speak. They never speak about money. They don't talk about it. They don't work together on it. So they're kind of both separate and it creates a lot of tension. It creates a lot of problems. And so what we want to recommend to you is that if it's not something that you can do on your own, go see a coach, a wealth coach, who can get the two of you guys together on the same page, especially someone that understands the different investing styles and can actually help you bring up your strengths and kind of downplay your weaknesses and bring up the strengths of the other person too, because both of you have very valuable things to add to the relationship and to the money situation.
Mm-hmm.
So with that, that's all we have to say on the gambler personality style and the investor style. So I want to ask you this, which investor style are you? Are you a gambler? Are you an investigator? Maybe you're one of the other two that we're going to talk about tomorrow. So if you fall into the category of gambler or investigator based on what we talked about, go ahead and leave a comment below. Be sure to click the like button, subscribe, and share this video with your friends.
And where can they get what kind of style they are? What test can they take?
Right. Good. Thank you. See, I forgot those details.
Mm-hmm.
So we have an investor quiz. Be sure to go to the TARDIS website and click on the investor quiz and you'll be able to take it for yourself. It'll give you your strengths and weaknesses, things to look out for. Both you and your partner or your spouse mm-hmm. should definitely check that out.
TARDIS.com,
and we look forward to, actually we'll put it in the description link below. So go ahead and use that link in the description box and take the quiz. And we look forward to hearing what type of investor you are. All right, see you later. Bye.